Although you might think that cryopreservation is a new technology, it has actually been around for longer than you might have expected. In this video, we will explore the origins of cryopreservation. Our story begins all the way back in 1918, the year the father of cryonics was born. Robert Ettinger was born in New Jersey. As a child, he loved reading science fiction magazines. One story that particularly stuck in his mind was the Jameson satellite. In this story, an eccentric billionaire launches his body into space to be preserved by the freezing temperatures and vacuum of space. His orbiting body is later found by a mechanical man who manages to revive his brain and install it into a mechanical body. This is what put the initial idea of cryonics into young Ettinger's head. A few years later, Ettinger almost lost his leg during the Second World War. Ettinger's father was dissatisfied with medicine's capabilities at the time, but later came across bone grafting. It was this breakthrough technology that saved Ettinger's leg, but also showed him that today's problems might be easily solvable tomorrow. In 1964, he finally published his famous book, The Prospects of Immortality. In the book, Ettinger outlines how people may be preserved using extremely low temperatures. He used his extensive scientific knowledge and love of the field to map out potential impacts of the development of cryonics. This book earned Ettinger the label the father of cryonics. But he was not the first to benefit from its conception. The first person to get successfully cryopreserved was James Bedford. After he was diagnosed with kidney cancer that later spread to his lungs, he decided that he had nothing to lose. He got cryopreserved immediately after his death in 1967 by Life Extension Society, who offered the service for free since it was the first time someone would undergo this procedure. In 1987, he was moved to the Alcor Life Extension Foundation facility, where he remains until today. In 1991, after 24 years in cryonic suspension, he was removed from his Dewar for a brief external exam. The evaluation status: external visual examination discloses a well-developed, well-nourished male who appears younger than his 73 years. So, there you have it, the origins of cryopreservation. If you want to learn more about the history of cryonics, make sure to click the first link in the description. If you would like to find out more about cryopreservation, please visit tomorrowbiostasis.com.